Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be teaching some basic SketchUp concepts by modeling Minecraft Steve. All right, so I found a sort of unrolled version of Minecraft Steve. And I'm just gonna import that image into, I just dragged and dropped it from off screen onto here and it brought it in. You can also go to File, Import, and find the image that way. You can just make sure that down here you have selected the file type. This file type is a PNG, so you just wanna make sure you have PNG selected, either PNG or all image files. All supported image files is right here. So that's what you would do for that. Now, what we want to do is, this is sort of like if you're going to print it out and fold some pieces, but we don't want to do that. We want to make him into a SketchUp model. But this gives us all of the textures that we'll need for all of the sides. So, and it's nice because there's some of these are the same, like his arms are the same. So we really just need to model 1, 2, 3, 4 things, and then we should be good. So the way to start is we want to start with his head because, well, we want to make sure we can identify him. So we want to turn the camera to parallel projection. That'll make it so that everything is flat when we look straight on, and then we'll go to standard view top. Now, the thing to be careful of here is that we want all of these sides to be equal. So that way, we're essentially going to make what this is and then start to fold the faces in. And in order to do that, all of our faces need to be equal. So that means that this needs to be square. So you see there, when this locks on, that means it's a square. You see this diagonal. So we're just going to estimate where this is. So you see that. And then I'm going to hit M for move, and then as I start to move, I'm going to hit Control, and that's going to make a copy, and then hit ×2, and that'll make another copy. Alternatively, you can just move each one. So for these, I will move each one. All right, now I'm going to copy this over to here. This looks like it's about half. So we're going to keep that. And then drag one of these guys down. We're going to hit Q for rotate and rotate that 90 degrees and then bring that up. And then select this line and move it down. We're going to stick to that green axis. And because it's not locking, we're just going to copy it instead of moving it. Close up this shape. I'm going to delete this line here, and then copy this in ×3, and then do the same with this. I'm going to hit Q here. Now when I start to rotate, it starts to drag everything with it, but if I hit Control, it'll let me make a new copy at 90 degrees. Bring that over here, then connect. And then I can copy this and put it down here. I'm just going to make this into a component. Let's say Steve arm. Copy it to here. And then we want to flip it. Then that means it's going to sort of mirror it along the red. So just place that there so we can see that as a reference a little bit later. And these actually look like his feet are the same. So we're going to put this here. But then we're going to make this a unique component. And right now when I click, the entity info says Steve's arm. We're going to change this to leg. Just Steve's leg. Okay. Now copy this, so I'm hitting move and then control, flip along red. So one of the things that I did earlier was just keep proportions Like when I moved his head, it was square. And then I kept the proportion. I just have that square that I made. And then this length is the same length as that. And that just, by doing that, everything will fit together nicely when we go and make him. Now I'm going to make this unique and call this body. And so like for here, you can start to see this general sort of idea of what's going on. You start to get like this metric that I don't need to draw this every time because it's already there. Okay? So we have all these things. Now what we want to do is click on this image that we have and do use as material. Now, if you don't have this window here on the right side, you just want a window default tray and hit show. It'll say show here instead of hide. And then under materials, you want to make sure that it says in model. And you can see that I have this Minecraft Steve version of that image that we just had. So I'm going to delete that background. Now when I select on this face, I hit B and then painted that in here. If I go to make, sorry, not make unique texture. If I click on this image and then go to texture position, you can see that I get that image and I can actually just drag this around and just position Steve's face where it needs to be. So let's try to get this as close as we can. That looks pretty good. And then hit enter, and there it goes. There's his face. Do the same thing. B, texture position. Just drag it. Try to get his head as close as you can. I'm using the mouse wheel to zoom in. We just want to try to get it as close as we can. B again there. So it looks like maybe we reversed SketchUp Steve's face, so not a big problem. We will just copy this to this side, delete it, texture, position. Obviously mouse wheel to zoom in. Try to get it as close as you can. Now this guy's a little tricky because you don't have any lines, but you can see here, that's where I want to line that up to. And then the last one, texture, position, and then I'm just using the left mouse to drag this around. And if for whatever reason, if you make any mistakes in here, it's not a problem. If I get real crazy, you can always right click. I'll go to texture and hit reset position, and you can start over. You know, because there's, you can see that there's some other options in here, like this will make it go out of whack, this will rotate it, just reset it, and then you're good to go. Just drag. Okay, so now we have SketchUp Steve's head. Now what we're going to do is select all of our lines here. I hit Q for rotate, and now I'm pressing the arrow keys on my keyboard. Left will make it go to the green axis, so I just want to lock to that axis and then hit 90 here. I'm going to do that for all these guys. just lock to the axis that I want. And because it's square, all of these should line up. But you see, I made a little mistake there. You want to make sure that you go to the pivot point when you're rotating these. And for these, I'm going to select all of them. And then we're going to close up his head. If you just get a little turned around, it's okay. Left click here, or left arrow key. You can see, there we go. So we have SketchUp Steve's head. I'm going to make this a component, so Steve head. And then we're going to rotate it up. So there we go. Now I'm going to do the same thing for the rest of these. We're going to speed it up so you don't have to sit through the whole thing since it's pretty straightforward. And then we'll come back through, we'll piece them together, and we'll make them be the right size. The last thing we want to do is scale Minecraft Steve to make sure that he is the right size. So I did a little bit of research, and apparently he's 1.85 meters. I live in America, and we use the imperial system here, so I did a little bit of conversion to figure out how tall he is in inches, which is 72.83465 inches. And we just want to make sure he's that height, because that's what he is in game. But to do that, we want to first draw a line over, so we have a vertical line that represents his entire height. So you see here, there's just a vertical line that's his whole height. So, and then I'm going to hit Control A to select everything. Alternatively, you could just select what you want from top left to bottom right. Everything within your marquee, this selection area, will be selected. And then I'm going to go to the tape measure tool and then measure this line. So it says he's about 6 foot, which is close to actually what he is. And then what I'm going to do is type in, after I measure that line and click the last point, is type in his actual height. So 72.83465. Hit enter, and it says, do you want to resize the model? So it's going to resize what I have selected. I'm going to say yes, and actually he's that size already. So everything is looking pretty good. All right, so that's that. Hopefully this video helped. If you thought it was helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.